The following program is a special presentation of the Big Ten Network, produced in association with the University of Iowa.
Coming up in this episode, the National Advanced Driving Simulator, Advancing Oral Health at Iowa, The Science of All Things Fluid, and Inside the Mind of a Big Ten Mascot, next on Iowa Magazine. Automobile safety has come a long way in 100 years, from seat belts to airbags to collision warning systems. But along with these improvements have come higher speeds and more traffic. Given how dangerous driving can be, how do we design safer cars, informed by the way people actually drive? How can we achieve realism without the actual risk? The National Advanced Driving Simulator at the University of Iowa addresses this with a high-precision tool that recreates the experience of driving, the NADS 1 simulator. This high-fidelity ground vehicle simulator was the first of its kind in the world and provides the most realistic virtual driving experience available.
Our mission is to help save lives. We believe that by having a tool that allows us to put human beings in a very safe and controlled environment, but yet allows them to drive like they would in the real world. A tool like that is invaluable in trying to figure out how we can lower the loss of life.
The NADS 1 consists of an entire vehicle inside a 24-foot dome with a wraparound 360-degree visual display system. A motion base with 13 degrees of freedom accurately reproduces the sensations of accelerating, braking, maneuvering, and interaction with the road surface. These features combine to give the NADS 1 an unparalleled level of realism.
Most people, they have a pretty good sense for what driving feels like. So we have to have a tool that replicates that driving experience really well, because the whole premise of the research that's being done on the tool is that when people get in and they drive the NADS 1 simulator, that they truly believe that they're driving a car.
A major study at NADS evaluated electronic stability control, an active safety system designed to help drivers maintain control of their vehicles in adverse conditions. Because research was able to show that the system was effective, the National Highway and Traffic Safety Administration made ESC a standard feature in light vehicles, estimating the system will save thousands of lives annually. Research at NADS isn't limited to studying vehicle systems. Vision studies on NADS 1 have focused on driver performance as well.
In the driving simulator, so in an artificial environment, you can put somebody in a position where things are going to happen that's truly going to test their ability to drive safely, where they're going to have to be able to scan efficiently, where they're going to have to read signs, where if they have an accident, it's not going to hurt anybody. And that's the nice thing, is we can actually truly test the person's ability to compensate for their acuity or field loss in that environment. You can't do it anywhere else.
Dr. Wilkinson's work, providing visual rehabilitation and advocacy for older drivers, is an example of how NADS research can help improve quality of life.
You know, as part of the Center for Macular Degeneration, we're seeing lots of people who have inherited eye diseases. Various problems, and one of the most important things is trying to help them to be as independent as possible, as functional as possible. So the research that's done at NADS is very helpful as we do our advocacy for people to be able to keep driving where it's appropriate, and then other people we have to tell it's time to stop or retire from driving, which is my favorite term. So
the NADS 1 is the highest fidelity simulator, but the center also houses NADS 2, a specially outfitted stationary simulator. The NADS 2, with its high-resolution display, is ideal for current studies evaluating night vision systems in automobiles.
At the present time, the U.S. government doesn't really have a scientific database of detailed information on how night vision systems in car perform, what sort of things you can and cannot see, and what sort of performance enhancements you can expect out of them with regard to, say, for example, avoiding pedestrians at night and so forth.
Like other studies at NADS, this research is vital because it informs policy regarding safety and transportation systems.
We want to provide the government with all the necessary information that they need for rulemaking to know exactly what sort of human factors questions might arise when you deploy night vision systems into automobiles.
As part of the Center for Computer-Aided Design in the College of Engineering, NADS continues Iowa's tradition of innovation in human factors studies.
And so we had the expertise and the vision to think about the idea of having a tool like this when a tool like this did not exist.
While automobile safety continues to improve with the help of centers like NADS, there will surely be more questions to answer as long as we use vehicles to get around.
I think driving simulation is just very much underutilized across various fields. There's a lot of promise for us to make a difference, and we're just getting started. So we have a lot of work in front of us.
To learn more about the National Advanced Driving Simulator, visit nadssc.uiowa.edu. Coming up, advancing oral healthcare at Iowa, next on Iowa Magazine.